I've always liked making stars in MATLAB. I don't know why. It just makes me happy. I think I like it because it's kind of pretentious because you have to know polar coordinates to do it. Now, if you remember about polar coordinates, the way you do that is you go out R, out, and you go around theta. So you go out R, you come up theta, and that's how you do polar coordinates. Strangely enough, though, in MATLAB, instead of saying R theta, they say theta R. Not entirely sure why, but theta R. What's kind of cool about polar coordinates is the idea that you can actually get to the same point multiple ways. So if I have, say, R is equal to 1, we'll just pretend that's 1. This is actually R is 1, theta is 0. But I could also say that this coordinate is R is 1, theta is 2 pi. I could also say that this is R is 1, theta is 4 pi. So the more times I go around, that's 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi, 8 pi. So the more times I go around, the more pi's I have, but it all stays in the same place. So, okay. So what's cool about plotting stars in MATLAB, once you think about, well, how do I make a star? And if I was going to make a star, I'd do something like boop, 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 boop. That's not a very pretty star. Let's make it prettier. I can't be obnoxious and then not do something pretty. Oh, like that. No, that's a terrible star. I should plan ahead. Let's see. The chonk, the chonk, the chonk, the chonk, the chonk. Okay, see, that looks better. All right, so I'm going to make some little goal marks so I don't mess up next time. So I'm going to go for here, I'm going to go for here, and then here, and then here, and then I should get a much nicer star. Well, if my numbers came out a little bit better. But I go, the chonk, the chonk, the chonk, the chonk, the chonk. And that's a little bit better. So a star, I can make a star. So if I make my star, as I start moving these little values around, these little dots, what I start to see is if I really want this to be pretty, then what ends up happening is they all end up being equidistant from some center point. It's not as obvious the way I'm doing it, but if I did it perfectly, it would, you know, look better. So the idea is once I get my points kind of aligned, and then I look, I'm about the same distance from here to here to here to here. All about the same distance. So now if I wanted to try, I'm going to come out here, and I'm going to go, make it this way. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that's a semi-decent star. Okay? So what does this have to do with polar coordinates? Well, think about how many times I'm going around the circle. So here I'm, I don't know, a third-ish around the circle, or a fifth, two-fifths around the circle, I don't know. And then I come around again. Okay, now I've passed the line, so this is my second time around the origin, and then I end up where I started. So I'm going to say that again. So, like, let's call this zero. Then this would be, like, I don't know, something like 135 degrees, and this would be, like, I don't know, some kind of other number degrees, like 300. And then by the time I come up to here, this would be like 400 degrees. And then I come around here, and that would be some 5 something. And then whenever I come back all the way around here, that would be 720 degrees. So what's kind of cool about it is the idea that as I go around, I can keep adding. You know, I should actually do this for real. But I can never remember what the value is. But the idea is that if I keep adding, like, blah, blah, pi, these numbers are actually equidistant apart. So how can I say this better? Let's see. I want to say it's kind of like a two-fifths, maybe. What is 4 pi divided by 6 points? 5 points. 4/5. That's what it is. It's 4/5 pi. So basically, I start here, I add 4/5 pi, and then I add 4/5 pi again, and I add 4/5 pi again, and I add 4/5 pi again, and I add 4/5 pi again. I'm going to keep drawing this stupid triangle or star thing until it makes sense. So this is 0, 0. Then this point is at 0, 4/5 pi. So not 0, 0, it's at 1, 0. Well, theta r, so we have to do with this backwards because this is MATLAB. So it's at 0 degrees or 0 pi and 1. And then this point over here, he's at 4/5 pi, 1. And then this point here is at 8/5 pi, 1. And then what's another 4? 12/5 pi, 1. And then 16/5 pi, 1. And then if I add another 4/5 pi, then this guy is 20/5 pi, 1, which is the same thing as 4 pi, 1, which is actually the same thing as 0. So the way that MATLAB plots things is it plots things in the same order that you write them. So if I tell it to go 0 to 4/5 to 8/5 to 12/5 to 16/5 to 20/5, then that's the order it's going to plot the points and connect them. So it's going to start by drawing a dot here at 0. And so basically what I'm trying to tell you is if I have thetas, and I have my thetas are 0, 4/5 pi, 8/5 pi, 12/5 pi, 16/5 pi, and 4 pi, then it's going, if all my r's are 1s, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, then it's going to start off here at the 0. It's going to go to the 4/5 pi, so it knows where that point is, and it's going to make a line between those two points. Then it's going to say, okay, my next point is at 8/5 pi, so it's going to make a line here. Then it's going to say, my next point is at 12/5 pi, and it's going to make a line there. Then it's going to add another 4/5 pi, make a line there, and another 4/5 pi, and make a line there. So that's actually kind of a cool little application on how to draw stars in MATLAB, and in polar coordinates in particular. Because if I wanted like a 7-pointed star, then I just have to add more points and change the little 4/5 thing, but I'm just going to keep going around in a circle. So let's actually give it a shot and try to program this in MATLAB. So if I want to plot a star in MATLAB, I'm going to start by typing the word function. Now the star itself actually doesn't have any inputs or outputs. Star. So it has no inputs, no outputs. I'm just assuming I'm making a 5-pointed star. Now, I kind of gave you the idea, but I want to create 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I want to create theta, and I'm going to start at 0. I'm going to start at 0. I'm going to increase by 4/5 pi, and then I'm going to go all the way up to 4 pi, and then I'm going to plot it, polar theta r. Save it, and now if I come into my command window and I just type in star, I get this lovely little star, and it's much better than the one I drew by hand. Now, if I want to make this a little bit less strange, I think, well, if I have a 5-pointed star, I'm actually going to draw 6 points, remember, because I have to go back to the first spot. So rather than doing this, I'm going to replace it with a linearly spaced thing. That way I don't have to worry about whether it really is 4/5 pi. From 0 to 4 pi, and I want 6 points. And for r, I can say, well, I want ones. I want a 1 by 6 of ones. So I'm actually going to go ahead and delete these. So if I say I want a 1 by 6 of ones, linearly spaced 6 points between 0 and 4 pi, then theoretically I should get something out of this. So I'm going to save it again. I should get the same picture. It's just a little bit maybe more elegant or maybe more obfuscated, but one way or the other, it's just another way to do it. I get the same answer. I'll see how that floats the figure, so we'll open it again. And where did you go? Right there. And there's my beautiful star.